I think that a lot of the men who are on TRT don't actually need it. Hi guys, I'm Cameron Day from DoubleTestosterone.com, and today I want to talk to you about testosterone replacement therapy and why I consider it to be the dark side of hormonal optimization. So, as you probably know, these days, most men are testosterone deficient, and testosterone levels are down pretty much across all age groups compared to where they were 20 or 30 years ago. Ultimately, it's a symptom of underlying health problems when you have low testosterone. So it's things like vitamin and mineral deficiencies, inflammation, insulin resistance, cardiovascular problems, a whole host of factors that can play a role in lowering a man's testosterone. The normal range of total testosterone used to be 300 nanograms per deciliter up to 1100 nanograms per deciliter. But they're lowering that scale because men are showing up with lower and lower testosterone levels. So 250 nanograms per deciliter is now the bottom end of what they call the normal range. Now, personally, I consider anything in the 500 nanogram per deciliter range to be suboptimal. But a lot of doctors will tell a man who has 300 nanogram per deciliter that his levels are okay because they're technically still in the normal range. Now, I'm talking about total testosterone numbers here, but keep in mind that your free testosterone should be around 2% of your total testosterone. And free testosterone is extremely important because even if a man has a good total testosterone number, but his free testosterone is low, he's gonna have symptoms of low testosterone. So when a man goes to his doctor with low testosterone, he's gonna be prescribed testosterone replacement therapy because that's the allopathic model. They say if you're low in a hormone, they'll give you that hormone and then they solve the problem. But of course, the underlying problems haven't been solved. All those health issues that I listed out earlier haven't been addressed. So you have a situation where your health is still compromised with all those same nutrient deficiencies, all the inflammation, the insulin resistance, but then now you just have testosterone in your system. So to me, as a holistic health coach, that's a suboptimal solution. And that's being kind, just calling it suboptimal. Because I actually help my clients to solve all their health problems and double their testosterone levels naturally. And that way they don't have to take an injection of exogenous testosterone. Now, of course, I acknowledge that there are some men whose pituitary gland simply doesn't secrete luteinizing hormone, doesn't secrete follicle stimulating hormone. But setting aside men with a pituitary condition, I think that a lot of the men who are on TRT don't actually need it. What they need is to clean up their diet. They need to clean up their lifestyle habits. They need to fix their circadian rhythm. They need to get better sleep. They need to get more sunshine, and they need to move more. A man can't just be inside all day, sitting at a desk, staring at a screen, because that's a recipe for low testosterone. If you're sitting indoors all day, you just don't have enough healthy physical stressors to tell your body that you need more testosterone. Now, I know this because I used to do all of those things wrong. I had a terrible circadian rhythm. I went to bed at midnight or later every night. I sat inside at a desk all day. I ate low-quality food. Drink a ton of alcohol, and never got sunshine, and I never exercised. Over time, all of that took a toll, and I ended up very overweight with extremely low testosterone. Now, that was 10 years ago, and as you can probably tell, I've fixed all those problems. Not overweight, my testosterone levels are over 1,000 nanograms per deciliter, all of my blood markers are fantastic. This is why I consider TRT to be a suboptimal solution for most men. Those men need to fix their lifestyle. And when they do that, their testosterone levels will increase. And also, this intense focus just on testosterone is a little bit misplaced because you need a holistic solution. So if you're just injecting testosterone, that's only solving that one problem. But there's a whole host of problems going on in a man's body that are causing his testosterone to be low in the first place. And so I consider TRT to be the dark side of hormonal optimization, or at least one of the dark sides, because going on TRT means that your body completely stops producing its own endogenous testosterone. So when you inject exogenous or external testosterone, the sensing mechanisms in your hypothalamus sees that you have adequate levels of testosterone and estrogen in your body. So it stops sending the hormonal signal to your pituitary gland, which then sends a signal to your testicles to produce more testosterone. So when those signals shut down, then the testicles shut down. So after a little while taking exogenous testosterone, all three of those organs start to shut down. The hypothalamus and the pituitary, they'll still be doing other functions, but they'll stop sending those particular hormonal signals. And the testicles will shut down the most because their only job is to produce testosterone and sperm, and they only do that when the pituitary is telling them to do that. So for a man on TRT, his testicles are going to shrink. They're going to get physically smaller because they're not being used. That atrophy of the testicles, it can be mitigated to an extent by injecting HCG. That's human chorionic gonadotropin. It's a substance that basically mimics the luteinizing hormone that your pituitary would normally produce if you weren't injecting testosterone. And so HCG will help keep a man's testicles from completely shutting down, and it's going to minimize the amount of shrinkage that they'll experience. But it doesn't preserve the signaling from the hypothalamus and the pituitary. And so there is going to be a little bit of atrophy even with HCG, but it's still better than doing nothing. But now at this point, a man on TRT is injecting two compounds. He's got testosterone and he's injecting HCG. Now, another problem though with TRT is that most men are just doing their injections once a week. And so when he does that, he's going to have a big swing of testosterone. And then over the course of 7 days, those levels are going to start dropping down. So by the sixth day, those levels are going to be pretty low. And so that usually means that a man doing that kind of regimen is going to be feeling pretty bad towards the end of that week before he takes his next shot. Then he feels good for a bit, and then he goes down again. So he has a big up and down. The men that have more experience on TRT, they figured out that if they split up their injections of testosterone into three doses, and they inject themselves three times a week, that they have more consistent levels. Now, of course, the downside here is that a man doing that has to inject himself three times a week, right? And I don't know about you, but I don't want to do that. And I think most men probably don't want to have to do that. But if a man's already been on TRT for a while, his endogenous production has already been shut down. So he's kind of stuck. So he's got to do whatever works. And so at that point, he's stuck with injections, and he's probably going to end up being stuck with injecting himself three times a week. So, like I said, this is the dark side of hormonal optimization, because whenever you're dependent on an external source for something that your body can and generally should be making on its own, there's going to be problems. What happens if something goes wrong and you can't get your supply of your testosterone? Let's talk about HCG. That's actually become much more difficult for men to acquire because the FDA changed some rules about it. So now a lot of men that were taking HCG don't have that available to them anymore. What if that happens to injectable testosterone? And right now, the FDA is actually talking about changing the rules in a way that's going to make it a lot harder for men to get TRT. But besides the FDA, what if there's a shortage of testosterone available at the pharmacies? That's actually something that happened recently to guys in my local area. They actually had some serious problems with their supply. They couldn't get it from the local pharmacies. The supply was drying up. If you're on TRT and your supply gets compromised, you're in big trouble because your body's endogenous testosterone production has been shut down from those injections. And it doesn't just turn back on just because you stopped injecting that testosterone. It stays off. So to turn it back on, you have to do what's called a recovery protocol, which isn't guaranteed to work. A recovery protocol involves taking a drug, something like enclomiphene, and it's a drug that tricks your hypothalamus into perceiving that there's no estrogen in your system. Because it's perceiving that, it's going to then send that gonadotropin-releasing hormone to your pituitary, and then the pituitary is then going to send luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone down to your testicles to tell them to start producing testosterone again. And if it all goes well, then you'll turn back on your natural testosterone production. But if you're not lucky, your natural production won't recover and you're still in big trouble. All of this means that going on TRT ends up being a life sentence for most of the men who use it. Now, of course, there are men who do TRT and they come off okay. They're able to restore their endogenous production. But sometimes, even after a successful recovery protocol, a man's natural production is still going to be lower even than it was when he first went on TRT. And I think a lot of men don't know the risk going in, but men really need to be fully aware of the biological reality that taking exogenous testosterone shuts down your endogenous production And restarting that endogenous production is not guaranteed. Now, there's a lot more to this dark side of hormonal optimization, but I'm going to talk about that in future videos. Right now, I want to wrap this video up with the light side of hormonal optimization, which is doing it naturally via holistic health methods, which is what I teach men how to do. So I show you how to work with your body, how to correct and heal the underlying health problems that led to low testosterone, erectile dysfunction, low energy, all of that. And so that means optimizing your diet so that you're feeding your testosterone production with every single meal. It means getting all of your micronutrient needs met, filling in those gaps in your diet with high quality supplements, and avoiding those garbage tier supplements that you're going to find at Costco or Walmart. It means dialing in your circadian rhythm so that you're getting great sleep every night. It means moving your body more, getting outside more, getting more sun. It means matching your exercise levels to your body's current capacity, and then slowly increasing those levels as your body gets stronger. I even show men how to rejuvenate their testicles so they regain lost size and they start to work like they did when they were in their 30s. And that means those testicles are going to be producing a lot more testosterone, and it means their libidos are going to start ramping up. And so to do all the research and the self-experimentation that you would need to get all of this right, it would take hours and hours of research every week and a couple of years of trial and error to get it all right, if you're lucky. Now, of course, a much faster approach is to work with a coach who can give you a roadmap of exactly what to do based on your body's current condition, and then show you how to get to where you need to be, how to fix your health and fix your testosterone levels. And so that's what I do. I give my clients a direct route from point A to point B, where we naturally improve all of your health markers, including your testosterone levels. And so the main thing I want you to take from this video is that you don't have to be on TRT for the rest of your life if you have low testosterone. You can fix your health and you can revive your testosterone levels naturally. Now, if you liked this video, be sure to click that like button, subscribe, hit the notification bell so that you'll know whenever I put out a new video. Also, leave a comment about anything you'd like me to talk about in a future video, or let me know about any experience that you might have had with TRT. Now, in future videos, I'll be going deeper into the dark side of hormonal optimization, and I'll be sharing more information about how you can naturally optimize your health and your hormones. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.